Abhyasa, please understand. Abhyasa means the first thing. Understanding your problems are neither permanent nor impermanent. Your understanding about the problems are not right. The next step for Abhyasa, second step for Abhyasa is coming back to your center again and again and again. For enlightenment, you need only three things. One, Abhyasa. Second, Abhyasa. Third, Abhyasa. Forget about enlightenment. Even for living an integrated life, even for living integrated life, all you need is Abhyasa. I can say, the Abhyasa can be understood from two angles, two ways. One, by constantly coming back to the center, letting everything else melt. Second, by constantly melting, not letting samskaras gather around you. See, relaxing from wrong abhyasas, resting in the right truth. Relaxing from the wrong abhyasas means your conditioning. Your conditioning, actually, you can understand Abhyasa in two ways. One thing, not letting any Abhyasa means practice happening inside you. Not allowing any practice. See, all your sufferings are because of your practices. All your sufferings are because of your practices. That's the reason you can see in your life. Everything is because of your practices. Man is not just a conscious being. His conscious level, layer, is only one layer. His unconscious layer is 9 times bigger than conscious layer. And his body is completely unconscious. Body is created out of non-voluntary habits, which has become part of your unconscious. Whatever your conscious does again and again, repeating, that becomes body. Anything repeated by your conscious becomes unconscious and becomes your body. You can see in your life. For example, driving. In the beginning, you need to put so much of effort. You have to do this, that, right turn, left turn. For each decision, the brain has to give the command, it has to pass through the hand, and it should be executed. But after some time, you will sit in your car, reach your office, only when you park the car and come out of the car, you will remember, oh God, last 1 hour I was driving. Sometime you even run over people. Anyhow, so many decisions you took, right turn, left turn, stopping at the signal, so many decisions, you are not even aware because it has become non-voluntary action, part of your unconscious. If you understand Abhyasa in this way, if you don't allow any Abhyasa, you are liberated, you are enlightened. Means every moment you will be fresh, alive. Your muscles will be so strong, alive. One more thing. Your Abhyasa is directly connected to your muscles. Anything you do again and again, if it is negative, it weakens your muscles. Anything you do again and again, with consciousness, it strengthens your muscles. That is why our rishis are saying, the more you age, more strong you should become. Of course, it feels paradoxical. They say, More you are aging means more experience in the planet Earth, more experience with your body, more experience with your mind. So naturally you should become more strong and intelligent. But something goes wrong in the whole cycle. Something wrong happens. We start encouraging negative abhyasas, negative ideas, getting stronger and stronger and stronger. See, when I say negative ideas, the unconscious things, they become stronger and stronger and stronger. Unconscious things do not become that strong inside our inner space. Somehow, basically, your being, by its nature, wants to be in a restful awareness mood. Being conscious and restful awareness needs a training which is not provided to you by the civilization or the society or the school or colleges. But being unconscious and relaxing into the restful awareness is taught to you by your colleges and universities and schools. Please understand, this is an important key. By your nature, you want to be in restful awareness. People come and tell me, I am too lazy to meditate, Swamiji. I tell them, just be too lazy to think, that's all. That is meditation. No, I am too lazy to go through programs. I tell them, you don't have to do programs, just be too lazy to think, that's all. You are in meditation. The problem is, two ways of restful awareness. One, being in the restful awareness consciously. Second, being in the restful awareness unconsciously. The second process is taught to you by your schools, colleges, universities. Nothing. In India I have seen, by the time this guy finishes his school and comes out, he has mastered the art of sitting and sleeping with open eyes. Teacher goes on talking. Poor guys. They are made to sit and windows are locked, room is locked. And the teacher, at least that guy should be very entertaining. And that poor guy, what he will do, he is talking about the same subject 25 years. The same subject, same maths or same science. He is talking for last 25 years. What he will do? He will turn towards the board and talk to board, blackboard. And these kids will be talking among themselves. He shouts back, hey, keep quiet, sit straight. Then they will sit. But somehow, the consciousness never gets involved with the life. Please understand, if there is no interest created, enthusiasm created about the things you are attending, if it is compulsion, naturally, by and by, you will master the art of disconnecting. Even your eyes and senses are open. When you need to sit and attend, if you are not interested, see, why you don't feel interested? Because you don't know the direct result. See, when you are in the schools and colleges, they don't take so much of patience to convince you about what you need to know. Because first of all, they are not convinced. They themselves don't know, by learning this, is it going to help you? See, it is generalized. First problem is generalization. Second problem, they themselves don't know what they are teaching is, whether it is going to be helpful for you in the life or not. So first of all, the teachers are not convinced about what they are teaching. And naturally, that expresses in their method of teaching. And the students are also not convinced about the utility value. There is so much of gap between the person who is designing the system and the person who is put inside the system. So much of gap. So the transmission of intensity and enthusiasm is disturbed. It's like a in Zen they have a example. They say, if you wash a cup in which the tea was there, and pour that water in another one cup, and wash that cup, and pour that water in another one cup, the last cup, will it know any taste or smell about the tea? No. No taste, no smell. This cup will no way know the taste or the smell of the original tea. Means the enthusiasm, the intelligence, the understanding never gets transmitted if the gap is too much. Same way, the designing, the education system, the designers and the person who is going through the system, the gap becomes too much. And for so many other reasons, because of so many other reasons, you are never taught how to be in the restful awareness consciously. You are always taught restful awareness means unconscious. Switch off, only then you can be in restful awareness. Then what happens? All your unconscious samskaras get strengthened. The abhyasa happens in you also, but unconscious level. Things which are not needed becomes abhyasa in you. Things which are not going to be directly helpful for your consciousness becomes abhyasa in you. See, in your life, anything which makes you unconscious, you make that a habit very quickly. Very quickly it becomes your habit, drinking, smoking, drugs, anything which makes you unconscious, TV. When you are watching TV, you don't have to think about you. You can constantly go on laughing at others, making fun of others. See, you need so much of entertainment. Why? Because you can't be with yourself. You can't be with yourself. India, the other day, near our ashram, they inaugurated a theme park. They requested me to come and inaugurate the theme park. I said no. They asked me, what is this, Swamiji? Nothing wrong in theme park. I said, I am feeling so bad. This country needs theme parks to entertain people. Means what? The depression level is going high. Depression level is going high. Now we need to invent more and more and more different entertainments. The great civilization, the Vedic civilizations, even their entertainment was conscious based. Prayer, meditation, different techniques, going to different places of worship, different energy centers, different energy fields. Even entertainment was conscious based in our civilization, in the Vedic civilization. But now I am seeing even entertainments need to be adrenaline based. Adrenaline based means moving your body fast, giving you kind of a surprise, shocks. All that roller coaster, everything is the entertainments which puts you unconscious. See, when the adrenaline release happens, you feel like a hero. It is literally like a dog eating its own leg. Please understand. It feels the blood, it enjoys the blood, but it doesn't know the after effect. It doesn't know it is eating itself. It is killing itself. You do not know the adrenaline release. It really entertains you for 5 minutes. You feel high. But you are entering into the unconscious enjoyments, unconscious entertainments, unconscious abhyasas. That is why so much of appeal about these horror movies. You know, after seeing that movie for 2 days, you can't relax. In the room, bedroom, even if small cat movement or dog movement or even screen movement. But somehow, even then, you again sit in front of the same movie. It's a kind of a unconscious abhyasa, entertainment. Means putting yourself into the unconscious layer again and again and again. So the whole civilization, because it is very easy, see, unconsciously falling in tune is very easy. Consciously falling into that restful awareness means you need to practice little, you need to meditate, you need to practice. And you are never taught from the young age that is easy. You are always taught this is the easy. You are never taught meditation is easy. That's a big problem.